What's going on, everybody? My name is Bo, and I'm a home theater enthusiast. And this is the final part, and I mean it, to my Front Wall Makeover. Now, if you haven't seen any of the previous parts, I'll link them all in the description below. And yeah, go check those out. I'm not going to recap them here. I see a lot more people watch part four than any of the other parts. So hopefully that trend continues because now I'm going to have the final product to show. I have the Focal speakers in my workshop. I'm going to go unbox one just to give you a quick look at it. Hopefully just snap them all into place because I have done some work off camera. Now I did the cutouts bigger according to the dimensions. I painted the cut edge of the drywall just to kind of keep the drywall dust down because stuff just gets everywhere. I made an additional acoustically transparent ceiling panel that I put in the front middle because my center channel is not about 2 foot further back than the old one, so the reflection point changed. I had a bunch of safe and sound insulation left over, so I used some of that, put it up in the floor joist, and yeah, that went really well. I spent quite a bit of time, a couple days, of just dialing in my screen mounts, making sure the top ones were level, and then adjusting the bottom ones so that when the screen came down, before the bottom of the screen came in, and then when it tightened, it lifted up, which kind of bent in the bottom. So I moved the mount down so it's just a snug fit. When you tighten it, it just holds it into place. So I had it up and down a bunch of times. I changed the spacing on the right bottom one because it was out a little bit further, and got my projector way better dialed in. Now, I couldn't get it perfectly square like I thought this mount would get me, but I got it a lot closer than I had previously. And shout outs to Matt in Atlanta, if you're watching this. Yeah, I had to tilt. I couldn't keep the projector level. I had to tilt it up. Even though the front face of my screen is level, the top's level, and it's square, it just didn't line up. It's not perfect, but it's pretty good. And then I just over zoom it just slightly, and it hides all that. But yeah, did all that in the last few days, and I think that's about it. So let me stop talking. I'm just gonna go into the workshop. We'll do a quick unboxing, get the speakers in place, start playing some music, put the front wall back together. For the first time, I haven't seen the wall with screen up, panels in place, and finished stage with lights yet. So that's going to happen. I'm really excited. So without further ado, let's get to that. All right, and here's a look at the Focal boxes, the 300IW LCR6. Now, I've already seen this speaker because I bought one from Crutchfield, which I returned because I wanted to purchase them from Ryan out of Kansas, because he really helped me work through a lot of things, so I want to give him my business. But here's just a quick look at the packaging, which I had already seen. These speakers are made in France, shipped to the U.S., and then he shipped them from the warehouse in Kansas. So yeah, wasn't new to me, but if you haven't seen these speakers before, they're pretty large. They have 2 6.5-inch drivers, 1 4-inch driver right above the tweeter. Nice looking speaker. Way better build quality than the Polk. So look at the tweeter, and then, ooh, here we go. We're in the room. I cut all the wire because it got insulation and stuff in them from when I was removing the other speakers and cutting the holes bigger. So let's get the wires hooked in and we'll get the speaker in place. I got to pull out these 6 spring-loaded tabs. Really cool mechanism. 1 million times better than the system that most speakers use. So here I'm trying to get it lined up, get the speaker wire out of the way. And it's looking pretty tight. I push in the bottom, and it just wasn't going in. It just was catching. So let's find out why. Okay. Well, I messed up. I didn't cut the speaker openings wide enough. Yeah, so I had to get the shop back in here. I'm hand sawing. I used the template. I held it. I drew lines. I thought I was cutting it. I thought 7.5 was like the middle, but that's the bare minimum. It goes from 7.5 up to like 7 5/8 or something. So I had all that prep work done, and yeah, so I've spent the last half hour cutting this little bit, trying to clean it up, and then repainting the inside, waiting for that to dry right now. It never goes as planned. So yeah, I'll just show some footage of the opening. You won't be able to tell it's any different, but yeah, so hopefully they fit in this time. So let's cut to that. And that snapping sound is very satisfying. That mounting mechanism is amazing. But here's a look at the speakers in the wall. Then I put the panels up and the stage. Got the LEDs working off the smart power strip. And yeah, it turned out really good. I was super excited with how it looked. And yeah, the color temp's a little warm. I might see if I can find some that are maybe 5000K like the rest of the room, but it does give it a nice warm look, so I might leave it. But yeah, that's a look at the front wall without the screen. Now let's see what it looks like with the screen. Here we go. Final look. Now it looks small in this photo. I don't know how to really make the scale come across, but yeah, I couldn't be any happier with the end result. I love how the panels finish off the wall. The lights, you know, highlight the acoustic panels, and you know, it looks really good. So I'm very happy, and with that, I'm gonna go get on camera after I watch some demos, try to tweak the audio, and I'll give you my final thoughts. So stay tuned. Well, after listening to music and some demos, it hurts my soul to say that it sounds pretty damn terrible. There's a bad boominess to the sound, like the speakers are getting too much bass. When I did the 80 hertz crossover after level matching, it like vibrated the hell out of my wall. I actually had to put screws into the boards on the side to stop that. So that's definitely, 80 hertz is definitely something's going on. I'm guessing there's a huge spike there with these speakers, but watching movies, nothing impressed me demo wise. I was trying with the bass and treble setting in my receiver. Adding treble and reducing bass does make the speakers themselves seem like they're more close to what I want to hear, but then it cuts the bass out of the subwoofer and just really kills the sound in this room. It's been a long night after having to cut those speakers openings bigger. Just nothing's going right. I'm even thinking about bringing my tower speakers down here, getting rid of the stage. You know, I don't want to get to that point just yet. I did watch a few YouTube videos that give me some hope. I ordered a UMic 1 calibrated mic. I remember talking to Tony from Build Montage about this like a month ago when I was talking about the Polks, and he said, basically, I need to get over this thing. I need to start using REW and taking measurements, because that's the only good way to find your crossover, set the distance, and really see what each change you make is, how it's affecting your sound. And then Audioholics had a video about Yamaha's web-based setup, and he said that you can go in, and I could adjust it right now without a mic, to go to 12,000 kilohertz or whatever, and you can adjust the gain up to at a 0.5Q, and really he said add sparkle to like your high end. Right now I just want to go to bed and try not to think about this, but I also talked to Ryan, who sold me the speakers, and he's going to help work with me, try to get this solved. Hopefully EQ can eliminate it. I mean, on my test wall I did, the speaker sounded amazing compared to the Polks, but actually putting it in my wall, like I said, it's like vibrating really bad. It's just like I said, must have some kind of spike around that range, and that's drowning out everything else. So hopefully I can get it close to what it sounded like in my little test wall. But I don't want to think about this. I don't want to talk about this anymore tonight. I think it's just a bad night. I need to start fresh tomorrow. It is already tomorrow, technically, how late it is. But my ears are shot. My energy's shot. So I'm going to fade to black. I'm going to come back, whether it's tomorrow, whether it's a week from now or 2 weeks from now. I'm not coming back on camera until I have a resolution and I know what's happening moving forward. And I'm going to consider this front wall project done. So for you, it'll be seconds. For me, it could be weeks, days. I don't know. So hopefully I got good news when I come back. I got a lot of stuff to figure out. So thanks for staying with me through this process. And we'll see you in a few seconds with hopefully some good news. All right. So like you've seen, it's been a week since I installed the Focal speakers and was devastated by how bad it sounded. Got the calibrated mic the next afternoon, but I didn't have the stand. I did some tweaking. I had to pull my computer way off to the side so the HDMI cord would reach my receiver. So I had to order a different HDMI cord, and my mic stand both showed up on Tuesday. So I didn't really mess with it for a couple days. I did try watching Netflix, Stranger Things. I watched the Batman. You know, they sounded pretty good, but I wasn't very happy. I was still using the bass and treble in the receiver trying to fix things because I was waiting. So I get it on Tuesday. First thing I did was what Gene from Audioholic said. I bumped up the highs using the manual EQ in the Yamaha. That helped. I got the crossover dialed in. Well, at first I had it at 120 because it looked the flattest. But Tony from Build Montage, shout outs to you. He mentioned maybe dropping it down to 110 and seeing how it sounded, and definitely helped with music to add a little more oomph back in the mid range, because those speakers are capable down below 80. It's just they're a little bit hot at around the 80 hertz range. So that crossover smoothed that out. I'm very happy with music. It's not as good, and it'll never be as good as my tower speakers, but it's good enough. And I had one issue with the calibrated mic. As an SPL meter, it was actually very inaccurate. It had my side surrounds down like 5 dB. Could barely hear them. And then it wanted me to raise my fronts up even louder. So I just used my receiver's pink noise. I level matched everything according to that calibrated mic SPL meter through REW. And I gotta say, I was pretty impressed. But my gut was telling me something was off. So I just used my ears, put up the pink noise. I could tell the side surrounds and the rear heights were way too low. I got up my old trusty SPL meter. It verified what I was hearing. So I don't know what's going on. Basically, I combined the results from my handheld and the, calibrated mic. I level matched with the handheld. I had the bass lower according to the calibrated mic's readings, and yeah, it turns out I had my subwoofer way too hot, which worked for some movies, but for like Godzilla versus Kong or Blade Runner, it just kind of was overbearing and I couldn't really appreciate the rest of the sound. So end of the day, I had to kind of go with my ears, and then I mixed my handheld SPL with the REW calibrated mic SPL, plus all the EQing I did. For being an amateur, switching back and forth from my manual EQ to just through input, no EQ, it's a pretty significant difference. So music sounds way better. I'm completely happy with listening to music. Like I said, I didn't trust the calibrated mic SPL because it wanted the fronts too loud, which made everything really loud. So I went with my handheld SPL meter, and so now I'm really happy. I'm pretty much feel like I'm ready for at least two more subs in the front, two identical subs. I'm thinking sealed because I want to keep them smaller, but I also don't want to, you know, sacrifice the benefits of ported. So I don't know there. It's going to be a while before I spend any more money. But I think I got the in walls set to where if I just can increase the bass output in this room and get a nice flat response with pressurizing the room. So if you have experience with multiple subs going from 1, 2 up to 3 or 4, leave them in the comments below. I'd love to hear it. And we'll end with some shots here. I'll just kind of show the final room the best I can. It's been quite the journey. If I had bought the calibrated mic with the Polks, I may have been able to make those sound good enough, save myself a lot of money, but now we'll never know because I ain't going back. This is going to be it for the front wall makeover for now. I mean, other than adding subs, which would be a completely separate video, I want to get a new lamp for my projector to extend the life of that, because I won't be buying a new projector as soon as I thought because of spending the money I did on the Focal speakers. So I got plans for a rear door with a diffusion panel. I'm either going to make one, or I found a person in Michigan who makes them out of this like really dense foam. I got a lot of things planned. I'm going to do some stuff to the ceiling, maybe switch out some acoustic panels for diffusion, or some absorption, I should say. So stick with me. I'm going to have a lot of content coming out home theater related. So thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.